Hi guys. So it's been a while since I've been at my art desk on a table, and I had some help to try to get it under control. If things sit around here for a little bit, it becomes a catch-all. So today, I want to try a watercolor tutorial by Paul Clark, who's a fabulous teacher. He's got a YouTube channel and he also has a Facebook group with filled with fabulous people, very encouraging. And I've now going to try to do one of his tutorials. So come with me down here at the table. Come on.
All right, so this is what we got. We have my glass pen. I will show you when that comes into play later. My brushes, my rags, and reused paper towels because I reuse things. My notes from watching Paul's videos. This one is Venice, and I've watched that several times. I've taken notes, so I don't have to watch it while I'm trying to create. I have a really good idea in my head, and so also my notes for when I get stuck or need guidance. I have Arsh 300, I think, pound. Or no, it's 140, but it is rough. Yeah, that's rough. Pencil and my colors. I didn't have exactly the colors that he used, but I do have the cobalt blue. This one, instead of being alizarin crimson, it just says crimson, so I figured that was close, right? And I only had, I know what that word says. Hold on. Medium. Medium yellow. So it is what it is, and we'll go from there. Water and my rinse water. Right now my rinse water is clean. We're going to start by wetting the paper. And we're gonna remember while going through this, be bold, brave, and beautiful, as Paul says. And I love that. So the first one we need to do is a mix for the overall color we're gonna lay down first in a variant. And so actually I need to get my my prop-up tool thing. Did you guys get that a lot? This, like, minty things on your paper? Or is it just my place? Let's see. Or does it really matter? I see. A lot of good that's gonna do on that tape. Okay, let's see. He says mix 90% yellow. waste it, go dunk it in there. 90% yellow. And 10% red to make a warm yellow. Now, did I get that ratio right? I'm not sure. Maybe that's too much. Stop that from running in there. And maybe that's too much, huh? And a little bit more yellow. It's a little more oranger, orangey-ish. Okay, so, where did my prep-up thing go? Here it is. Just a wooden block. Didn't take that into account when I set my thing up here. I just put my finger in paint. That was good. Did you see that? Right there. Oh, maybe that's old dry paint. But I did. I put my finger in my watercolor paint. Okay. I think that's soaked in enough. Let's make sure my tape is holding because I noticed it was flipping up. Let's see, get that right. Okay. This is an old cabinet I saved from the, you know, the old slider medicine cabinets. I saved it from the landfill. Okay, so a little gradient, right? And then lay it on heavy coming up from the bottom. And maybe get this. Can you see the tone? Let's see. I still have pretty harsh lighting, don't I? Let's see if it's dab this and then go across there again. Go across there. What do you do with the hairs? I mean, I've used this, about 4 times, I think, and it's still dropping hair like that. Is it because it's one of these? I don't know. I think I want it a little more darker down here. Or not darker, stronger? Yeah? And now we let it dry, huh? Okay. While it was drying, I was searching for some, a couple other things I'm gonna need for later. I came back to it and I looked and, guess what I forgot to do? And I say it right here. Lift blob for sun. yeah, so hopefully, it will still lift. Maybe not this one. Maybe I need this one instead. Yeah. So So this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna try to lift somewhere around here. But it might be already too dry. It is. So thirsty brush, maybe? Let's see. Tick-tock, and here, I guess, just... Oh, wait, no, I'm supposed to do it like this. Hard water thing, huh? Oh, maybe not if I soap it up with this. I might crud. Well, well, maybe it's a really, really, really hazy day. Uh-oh. Well, it's a good thing it's rough paper, huh? Oh, no. Ew, I think that's making it worse. Oh, no. Okay, well, I'm gonna let it dry and try to salvage that spot later. Okay, don't touch it. You touchy. Okay, I'll be back. So while that's drying, I get to enjoy nice creamy root beer float. All right.
Try to do this. I let it dry, I had a treat. Yeah, oh yeah. Yeah, so, a bit of tea light. And, we're gonna do the waterline and the sparkles as a resist. Great. Oh, first. This is totally dry. Get my tape again because I didn't stretch my paper, so it's still buckling. Yeah.
So. Is that too dark? I think that's too dark. See what that does. Oh, what am I doing? I'm smearing the wax thing. What am I thinking? Oh boy, I bet you I just smeared that. Okay, well. Percent red and 40% red. And 60% blue. I don't think that's the, right. Get some more blue. I mean, red. that'll be real good, Ange. Pretty good. Okay, so now I rewet the top very lightly. Some purple going in the clouds. Okay. Then the way that looks. just can't leave anything alone. I should have just left it alone. Look at that, now I've got stripes. Stop it. Okay, let that dry. Bottom and put in the whip speed strokes. Okay. Now the same color with the bottom. I don't have any puddles anywhere. Now, wispy strokes. Seeing those get wonky, look at them. They're like crookedy, wonkedy. Okay. Now to let this dry and have a bit of chocolate mint. Right, so I think we're on colors, slightly with the bottom. So we gotta mix up for the buildings and and it's time to be bold. Let's see. So yellow. Okay, now this is completely dry. Is that dark enough? Maybe not over on this side, huh? Oh, let's see. Good. Jesus spires. Ah. And I'm gonna try this one out. So that looks funny. Maybe you should stick with what Paul said. Yeah, these are two, the super thin baby hair lines, and that's awesome, but I think I got this.
No, it's okay. It's just the dinner. I'm almost done here, as far as this phase goes.
Okay, so this is that resist line that I laid down, and you can see a couple more here. I think it turned out okay. Oh, here we go. That's better. But you know when I was erasing or trying to erase that pencil line, and I had forgotten that, you know, I had already laid down that wax line. So I think when it smudged it, it probably also took some of it up. Anyway, it didn't take very well right here. But it did a little bit. And I'm thinking it's okay, though, because with the sun shining right here, maybe it would obscure those waterline lights, if you will. Anyway, so I think it still works. And I got a little not quite right with my detail on the buildings, but so what? It's not really Venice anyway, right? So now it's time to lay down. I have the pastels. I got this off eBay in auction for cheap, and I know that they're older, right? But they're there, and I'm going to use these, and I haven't used them yet, so I don't know how hard or not they are. And then I also have these that I got online for, I think it was free, just pay shipping, that kind of deal. So, those will work. Okay, I'll get you back up there.